Hey there, here's Daniel from Clockwork Origins. Today we are going to play Hero Mode of Elemental War. And as I mentioned in the video regarding the editor, we are going to play the map we created there. So I choose the single player, Hero Mode, Master Difficulty and Random Mode. And usually we start here on the official maps, but we can switch via the mods button to the mod maps, and the map we created is already selected here. So it's called Plus Box, the swamp setting, two portals, so that's what we created. So I click start. So what's the important part about Hero Mode? What makes it so different from Classic and Survival Mode? So basically it's kind of a mix of these two. So in Classic Mode you have fixed waves. So on wave 1 always the baby is spawning, on wave 2 always the spider. While on Survival Mode, the special thing is that there are no breaks between the waves, and there's no end. So, or better said, the end is when you don't have any lives left. And Hero Mode is the mix of those two. So you still have fixed you have waves with a break between them, but there's no end. So you will play until you have no lives left, like in Survival, but there are waves with breaks between them. But the waves aren't fixed like in Classic Mode, so there's not always wave number 1 with baby and wave number 2 with spider, but instead every monster in our monster pool can be the first monster. So for example, the T-Rex can be the first monster, and yeah, that makes it less predictable. There are also some other things we will notice while playing. So I will keep let the game run again, open the minimap. So a new thing for the release version is the interest countdown. So there was a feature request that we add some visualization of the time until the next interest is given or granted. That's this progress bar here. So after 15 seconds it will reach the end and start from the beginning. So we can let it run till the end. So you always see when you will get more money. And when you reach the end, then you see how much money you got as interest. So it was 1 gold because we had 50 gold. We saved 50 gold. So, here are the first monsters. As you see, it's not the baby, it's a giant scorpion. And there's a new icon, so when we select it, we can hover it. That's the monster ability. In Hero Mode, every monster, every wave, has one ability. In this case, it's the Gemalion ability. That means the monster will get the element of the tower that attacked it last. So it has water, and when I build some ballista here and the ballista hits it, the element changes to neutral. So it becomes more resistant against elements, but we can also use it as tactic. So if we add some tower first, that adds an element that has an disadvantage against the tower we build later, then we can deal more damage. So another thing in Hero Mode is we have quests. With quests we can unlock new items, and items are very important to beat these waves of enemies because they give us special abilities or improve our towers or weaken the monsters. So when we solve a quest, we unlock an item. This is added to our inventory for the current game. and also added to our item pool. The item pool is the list of all items we have unlocked so far. So around 30 items are available from the beginning, and another 20 can be unlocked via quests. From this item pool, 5 items are hidden on the map, so we have to build a tower somewhere, and if you're lucky we build it on an item, and when we build it on an item we get the item in our inventory. And the normal way of getting items is by beating the elementals. Every elemental will drop an item too. And yeah, the elementals work the same way as in classic mode. So every fifth wave we get a crystal, and with a crystal we can summon an elemental. As I'm playing in random mode, the elementals will spawn automatically. So we continue the game. We see kobolds, they have the Wimp ability, so that means they are way stronger than, way weaker than normal. That's a good thing for me, so they are easier to beat. So we can speed up the game. Yeah, 3 times is enough. So hobgoblins, they have the turtle ability, that means they are slower but have more defense. There are also some skeletons, so they are getting stronger now. The recoil ability. So let's build 2 towers here. Ah yeah. Here you see we have some special event called Ghost Light. So every environment in hero mode has special attributes and special events. The special attributes are there from the beginning and can happen from time to time. So for example, in Swamp we have the ability attribute that monsters can stuck from time to time. So we have a swamp, and of course yeah, they can stick in there. That means they are stunned for 1 or 2 seconds. And the special event, or one of the 2 special events here, is this ghost light. That's also a monster. You see it has a lot of hit points. You can't kill it. And yeah, it attracts all firepower of your towers. So if it's in range of a tower, then the tower will always attack the ghost light instead of the monsters. That's something you have to keep in mind, and that will cause trouble in some cases. Maybe we can see the other event 2 later, but at the moment there isn't anything to see. So yeah, these monsters, the skeletons, have the recoil ability. That means 50% of the damage they receive will be forwarded to the enemy behind them. So if you have a chain of skeletons here, they would always get 50% of the monster in the front until there's no damage left. So the hobgoblin won't be a problem. Zombies, hopefully be a problem too. Then we have the first elemental. You might have heard the sound. It's new for the final release. So every time an elemental spawns, there's a new sound to tell you, wow, there's an elemental. So we killed the fungoid, and we received the first item. So here we see the item in our inventory. You can open it via this button or the tab. It's a passive item affecting the monsters. It's called the poison fumigator. And you see in the tooltip that it weakens the enemies. So all enemies now have 5% less hit points than they would have without this item. So that's a good thing for us. But these dragons have the solidarity ability that means when they are next to another dragon they get a bonus of 50% hit points. So we have to either separate them or kill one of them so they don't get their bonus. So you see 283, that's too much. And I guess this one should have less hit points. I can select them. Let's take that one. Yeah, this one has just 180. But they are coming too far, so I will upgrade my towers. And I would also say we set them to runner, so they attack the monster closest to the end portal. Yeah, and here we see there's another ghost light, and this tower now has to attack this one instead of the dragon. Which is not that great at the moment, because the dragons are close to the end. But I got them down. So, oh, they have the double time ability. So the more monsters are behind it, the more damage it, the more hit points it has. This can be become quite annoying, but not at this level. It's no problem. Ah yeah, here this juggernaut was stuck for a second. So there will be the next elemental after this wave. Let's see what we will get. Electricity would be nice. Ah, it's Earth. So let's focus that. So now we received the Fabled Pot of Gold. That's an item that can be unlocked with the final release version, so we added a new quest for it. And yeah, we get now one gold for every 45 gold we have as interest. So you see here, usually it's one gold for every 50 gold, and now we have it for 45. So we get more gold more often. Or not more often, but more gold. So there's another ghost light. Ghost lights suck. And let's build an earthquake tower. The earthquake tower deals damage to all monsters on the map. You see, that's pretty good at the moment. Oh, and it deals twice the damage against Shadow. That's not necessary at the moment. So. So let's build an earth tower here. Oh yeah, that's also a nice ability, that's the random ability. So every monster in this wave will get another random ability. So like here, that's the piggy bank, this monster gives me twice as much gold as usual. This one is the thief, so it steals my gold and increases its hit point and speed. This one has the aura of frost, it slows my towers, you can see here. So it has just 0.3 attack speed, and the usual one would be 0.5. Yeah, this one is also slower. That's not great. Yeah, but the good thing is the earthquake tower is out of range. The old oak is too far already. I think I can get it down. Ah, this Dragonite will reach the end. So I lost the first lives. But the old oak is dead. So upgrade the two nature towers. So it's better now. Oh, that's also a mean ability, disturbance. So when it dies, it will block all towers in its range. So in a range of 50 meters. So it will always block these two if they get it killed somewhere here. See here. Okay, it works when the nature tower kills them because they are far away. So we received the arcane shield generator from the second nature elemental, from the old oak. You see here is a shield. Every monster that passes through this shield will get damage. So if they just have a few hit points left, then we will get them killed by the shield. So it's a last chance to save a life. So water killed. We received the Lich Lord's frozen staff. That's an active item we can use to freeze all monsters on the map for 2 seconds. And we have some new tower options now. So we can build the poison tower here. And let's say also a mud tower. And then let's also build the mermaid. Then we have good base to work with. So you see we can slow them pretty good at the moment. And yeah, they're coming up that far. Is this already level 2? Yes. So now it would be great if we would get Earth level 2 as the next elemental. I hope we are lucky. No, we aren't. But we get Water level 2. Ah, what I haven't mentioned yet. So in Hero Mode, not only the normal monsters, but also the elementals have abilities. And the elementals have special abilities. So we have a pool of around 50 abilities for the normal monsters and 21 for the 21 elementals. So they have unique ones. For example, the Kraken can hide when being attacked. That means it can't be attacked for a while. And every elemental has its unique ability. For example, the Phoenix, the fire level 1 elemental, has a cooldown, and if it survives longer than the cooldown, then it can respawn. The respawned version is weaker, but yeah, you have to beat a monster again to receive the element. So now we got the Bloodseeker side. That's a cool item because it moves the path along the path and hits all enemies that are there. And especially on this map, it hits all monsters for both paths because they walk the same path, just in a different direction. It deals just a little damage, but every little helps, I would say. But we still lost some lives. But these gargoyles aren't a problem. Fire golems might become a problem. Ah, yeah, here's the Phoenix, so you can see the ability. When we don't kill it fast enough, then it will respawn. Then we will build a water tower here. Water tower will help beat the Phoenix. It's already set to runner mode. Yeah, that's something that can happen in hero mode or in random mode, that we don't get the element we want. Like earth would be great, but now we get fire. And we have to make the best out of it. But hopefully we will still have a chance. So the Mithril Chassis is our first equipment item. So there are also items that are neither active nor passive, but we have to give them to a tower. The Mithril Chassis gives a bonus of 25% on the range of a tower. So I can give it, for example, to the Mermaid to increase its influence, its range to slow down the enemies. Because the Mermaid has the ability to slow all enemies in its range by 50%. So now it also gets all these monsters here. So then we slow down the game a bit. Freeze the monsters. We got a little more killed before they pass through the end portal. So now we... Oh, I missed that we already beat the fire elemental. So I add the pulp tower here. It's an improved poison tower. you see it has splash damage again, so it helps a lot here in this spot. So there are no monsters close to the end portal at the moment. But these fat ogres are also strong. So they have a lot of hit points and they teleported. So they could spawn almost anywhere on the map or on the path. Ah, and now there's a really, really mean ability. So the charisma ability causes towers to attack this monster. So it's actually similar to the ghost light. Yeah, that's a problem now because we also have to defeat these monsters that are close to the end portal. And there's no good way of doing that. But I will try to fire Earth Spike Tower, and then we add the Fire Earth Water, the Stun Tower, so we can slow down the monsters even more. And the Spike Tower will deal damage to all monsters here. It's also a good spot for this Spike Tower. Maybe we get at least some of them killed. Doesn't look too bad, but also not perfectly fine. It's time for the next elemental after this wave. So they have the healer ability, that means they will heal other monsters. But yeah, just every few seconds, 10 seconds. So there's the fire too. Hope we get it down first round. Okay, the crabs don't have a good ability at the moment. I guess we can beat him. And these scorpions aren't a big problem either. Good. So we have fire, nature, water, so we can upgrade the pulp tower. You also see this with this indicator, with this arrow. Upgrade this one. And yeah. That's it for now. It's great to have it on level 2. Will help a lot. So the Manticore has the hide ability, so it can become invisible every 10 seconds. Invisible means I can't target it, but that only affects towers that have to choose the target. So everything, so they can still be affected by splash damage or by area damage and global damage. So they have a problem against all my towers. Or at least all the strong towers. Oh. This ability is also mean on this map, or with my combination here, because they are immune against status changes. So they, for example, aren't affected by my mermaid. And yeah, can just walk around as usual. Maybe I will use some lives now. Can also try to do something with the quad ballista. Maybe I should build another 2 spike towers. Here and here. And let's say. Okay, we have to wait until it's upgraded. So, then we give this the Quad Ballista, so that means the tower gets 200% attack speed bonus. And the damage is decreased, but that means he attacks very fast now. Or a lot faster than before. You see, that helps. We have 3 spike towers now. Will get all of them killed. Now there are the babies. They have the regeneration ability, so they heal themselves. But that won't help them. I will destroy them. So I guess we can speed up again. This blue elemental looked like a werewolf. This. Let's focus it. Guess it won't be a big problem as most of my towers deal twice the damage. So when you hover the elemental icon, you see the element and you see its damage factors. So it has minus 100% resistance against fire and earth, so that means they deal twice the damage, but 20% resistance against shadow and 50% against water and nature. So I, for example, my pulp tower is nature, so it deals half the damage, but all these spike towers and the stun tower are earth damage, so they deal more damage now. Unicorns have the vulture ability. That's the lazy. No problems here. Okay, shadow is done. Got the money. Oh. Increased interest rate. Every 13 seconds instead of every 15 seconds. That's also a good thing. So then we build a shadow tower and let's build a pentagram tower here. Also build a pitch tower. Fire, shadow, earth. The powerful T-Rex. But you see, we can beat it. There's no chance against our army of towers. Giant beetle at the gold rush, so it gets stronger the more gold I earn while they are on the map. Already have more hit points than the T-Rex. So the stone golem is kind of a tank, so it has the ability to stop on the map, and while it's standing it gets a lot of resistance bonus. So this will happen soon, I guess. So now it's in stand mode and has its damage bonus, its hit point bonus. That means it's very hard to beat. Now it's easy again, so I have to defeat it as fast as possible. So let's say I add here and here a death tower. Shall attack the closest to the end portal. So, yeah. So earth elemental is down, so I can upgrade all earth towers. That means the earthquake tower, that means the mermaid, and that means also that one, and all of these spike towers. And it would also mean I can upgrade this one, so I give this the 10% bonus range, and as soon as I have enough money, or I have enough money, we deal more damage, have more range now with the stunner. That's nice! Already received its first kill. It's here. 4 kills, 3 kills, 5 kills. Ah, but we still lose some lives. That's it, right? Maybe I can freeze the kills. Doesn't look like. So let's build some more death towers. Maybe I can. Yeah. OK, Okay. The Death Tower's got at least some of them down. Death Tower has a chance to instant kill enemies. So now it looks better again. You see, this map isn't that easy to beat. We have this one path here, the starting and end area. There's a lot of trouble, but as soon as they are here, then it gets worse because I don't have that many towers here to hold them back. So let's upgrade this to Earth 3. What do we have here? The thief ability. Ah, so we already looped through the first time. So we had all abilities available once. Now in the second round. Minotaur. Minotaur has the final spurt. It becomes faster the closer it is to the end portal. So it's good when I kill them right at the beginning. But it's always a good thing, but especially for them. Next wave, lizard warriors. So let's speed up again. Here. Yeah, nature is a little problem because all my towers deal earth damage, so they deal half the damage against them. Zombie dragons. Ah! That's one of the really cool elementals, or elemental abilities. The Leviathan has the ability to make it rain. So when it spawns, it causes a thunderstorm, which means all towers have less attack range. But actually, that was not a problem for me. And I received the vibrating crystal, which means I get an additional crystal, which means another elemental spawns. So I get two elementals in a really short time. Upgrade that one. Fire, earth, water, that means I can upgrade the stun tower afterwards. Just have to beat the air rock. That's no problem. So it looks pretty good at the moment. Problem. Okay, that's similar to the Gold Rush ability, so they get stronger the more monsters die. And actually there are a lot of monsters that are dying. That could be a problem. But it doesn't look like a problem at the moment. Again. So Eater gets stronger the more monsters are on the map. But I hope there won't be a lot of monsters. The Shadow, that's good because I deal twice the damage. Ah. And the next elemental, the vampire. It's Shadow 2. So the vampire has the ability to transform into a vampire bat, but only if it passes like 60% of the path, which didn't reach. So now all my elements are at least on level 2, it means I can upgrade some of them again. Especially, oh, the pitch tower is useful, even increase its speed. That one should be improved, and that is very important. Death Towers would be nice. Oh, this would be expensive. And that's it, I think. Let's upgrade that one. So, with Water and Shadow, I could add a Freeze Tower here. Water shadow. Then we can add water, shadow and earth. Slime tower, so freeze tower will of course freeze the enemies and slime tower will slow them. So we have more time to get them killed here. With all our spike towers and stun tower. And of course our poison. So bloodthirst should be a problem. There's already the next elemental coming soon. Demon Lord, that's Shadow level 3. Let's focus on that one. This ghost light is distracting my towers from their real task. The demon lord is no problem. Even freeze it. So now we got the fire tornado. See it here. It's like the side. It moves along the path and will slow all enemies and deal a little damage. It hits. So yeah. In the end, it will hit every enemy here. Okay. Upgrade that one to level 3. That one to level 3. That one. Let's see. That's just level 2. No problem. Another enemies are coming closer to the end. Not close enough yet. Finally got them down again. Resistance ability, so they don't get slowed down. The Pegasus has elemental advantage against my Earth Towers. So you see what harm element advantage can do. So it already reached half of the path. Close to the end. My death towers have to get it down. They do the job. Oh, that's a really great item. So the Arcane Mortars give a tower area damage. That means they deal damage to every enemy in range. They deal a little less damage and have a less chance of hitting enemies, but in the end it's a really great item. I just have to find the right tower for it. Maybe something like that. Just in a good position. Oh, maybe the mermaid. Or I build a second mermaid. Let's say here. Let's try that. The mermaid is nature, earth, water. So we have it here. Then we give it that item. And let's say we use the... okay, we have to wait until it's built. No, we don't have to wait. Increase it. Ah, yeah. So now it has a chance. It attacks more frequently than every 2 seconds. and hopefully it will get some kills soon. At least, yeah, the monsters are dying pretty fast now, so that means it has some effect. But I still lose some lives now. Oh no, I didn't lose any lives yet. There's two more close to the end. No, I lost a life. But yeah, we are already at wave 77, so we are pretty far. Haven't expected to come that far, especially after the beginning. So we can add, say, nature, water, shadow here. Oh, and I saw we can also build a choker. That's a tower I really like. It's not that good when building it, because it has the normal damage, but every 2 minutes it changes its position and its damage type, so it become can get global damage. And with global damage, this tower is really cool because, yeah, it deals damage to all enemies on the map, and for that its damage per second is really good. Not on level 1, but on level 3, or level 1 when we are on, let's say, wave 20 or something like that. At the moment it's not that great. So, we have another equipment item, so increase the attack speed of the mermaid here. Still has no kill, but I guess it's a good supporter. And in worst case, it's slowing the enemies. So there's the next elemental. Hippogriff. 100 million hit points. Beat. Yeah, and of course now we have a teleport wave as well, so they spawn anywhere. My guard towers insta-killed them, but now they have to wait for their cooldown to finish. Yeah, that's also a new feature. So they making sound now when roaring. The other monster towers will also get this sound, or sound for them. It's work in progress, and I hope it will be done until Friday. So when making this video, it's Monday the 15th of July. We are going to leave early access on Friday 19th. Three element. Oh, the hippogriff is still alive, but that shouldn't be a problem. At least I hope so. Yeah. Oh, another great item. So, excuse me. With the arrow slit technique, we can give one of our towers an additional target. So, for example, we can give it to, yeah, let's say this spike tower. Then it can attack two enemies at once. So you will see this after when he attacks the next time. So he has two rows of spikes. Not that useful at this time in the game, but in general that's awesome. So now we can also build a root nexus here. It's nature, earth, air. The root nexus gets damage for all towers in its range, so it deals 200,000 damage. These monsters have 60 million, okay, so that's not good enough, but let's build some volcanoes. They are good damage dealers and will buff my root nexus. Maybe I don't buff it enough, but at least slightly improve it. So let's move to the end. Argus, 64 million. So you see it's getting hard at the moment. Yeah. There are spiders with scoring on ability, so they will buff every enemy in its range. That's why this ant hit over a billion hit points a few seconds ago. Joker is dealing area damage at the moment. Points. Get some of them down, but not enough. I guess we are close to the end. But yeah, wave 88 is really, really good. So now we received nature level 3. That means we can upgrade the earthquake, upgrade the mermaid. That mermaid. You can also upgrade the pulp tower and the poison tower. Oh, and all our spike towers. So we can deal way more damage now. And all death towers. And then I would say we stack it. This one is a major arcane crystal to buff it even further. So it attacks two enemies or sends two waves of spikes and deals more damage. So maybe that helps a little. At this point in the game, not too much. Enemies. Also no big saver. But I guess we are really close to the end now. That one. Some of them are dying. Yeah, but we reached wave 90, that's awesome. Wow, this might have been my best score in hero mode so far. The sad thing is that mods don't count in the global score. So yeah, maybe I should make this map an official map, so it counts into the score. So you can see now I'm on first rank on this mod map. And yeah, it's 30,000 points before my... Oh, almost 40,000 points before my previous number one score. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Watch our other videos and of course leave your opinions, your feedback. And if you have wishes for other videos, yeah, talk to us. We always want to hear what you think. So thanks for watching and goodbye.